Thank you so much, Jamie. We want to welcome a special guest here. It is hard to believe that the Las Vegas Massacre, the one-year anniversary, is happening tomorrow. There are artists from around the world who have been commissioned to do works to help bring, I guess, a sense of appreciation to the families, what they've gone through. And we have artist Elizabeth London, who is from St. Louis and has been chosen to do a work. You've painted a portrait of whom?
Her name is Jennifer Parks. She's one of the women. Her and her husband were both attending the Route 99 festival, and she was unfortunately shot in the head, and her husband was shot in the arm while trying to protect her.
So. And you've done this work, and it is in Las Vegas right now. Talk about what will be happening this week.
So this week there is a huge exhibit and reception happening where 58 artists from across the world. It's not just the United States, it is Greece and South Africa and Canada. Will be gathering to meet the strangers that they painted for in these families, and just to give a gift of God's tangible love, I think.
And talk about just what I guess an awesome responsibility it must have been to paint this, and what you felt as you created this work.
Yeah, so when I was doing this piece, you get a pamphlet, you go this interview process and this application process to be one of the artists chosen, and you have to go through 58 people and their biographies and to know their families and their kids and their husbands and wives, which makes somewhere so far away seem so close, because this could be my mother or my sister or my best friend, and you have to choose one. You have to tell 57 other families, basically, that you are choosing this person. So there was a lot of praying and a lot of God leading me to pick this one specific person in order to get to the family. And it was a beautiful experience. It was very hard. It's not easy painting someone who has passed away or was murdered. Because you bring that on, especially as artists, it's just very emotional. And with faith and praying and constant focus on God, it got me through that painting.
You felt it was important to do?
100%. It's when, I don't know, but when God tells you to do something, you just do it.
And so what do you expect will happen when you arrive in Las Vegas? You'll have a chance to meet this family.
I will. He has asked me if I wanted to meet sooner or after the portrait project, and I really want to tell him why I chose his wife, because it's this beautiful journey of how I hated art and I didn't love it, and God said, I'm going to put you at this place called The Crossing, and I'm going to put beautiful people in your life that's going to make you re-fall in love with art and do stuff for me. And I love sharing that kind of journey with people, and so I'm very excited to meet him and tell him that.
Well, it just sounds like a powerful event. I can only imagine what it will be like there in Las Vegas. And again, artists from around the world asked to create these works, and Elizabeth London here from St. Louis, one of those artists. We really appreciate you coming in and sharing this, and what do you hope that your work will do?
I hope that it gives the community a feeling of love and healing, and that God is in the process of being with you all the time and during that grieving process, and he cares about how you're healing.
Nice to meet you. I appreciate it.
Nice to meet you, too.
Thanks for coming
Thank
in.
Thank you.
Also happening, a local country radio station will be taking part in a National Moment of Silence Monday. That is to mark 1 year since the shooting massacre at that music festival in Las Vegas. New Country 92.3 joining other country stations, record labels, and those in the industry for a 58-second moment of silence. That number marks the number of lives lost during that shooting. The moment of silence will happen at 12:05 p.m.